Hello there, welcome back to another episode of Adopted by the Lionesses. So much controversy going on in the world of football right now. Just because the Premier League season has come to an end doesn't mean that the football world doesn't still revolve throughout the summer. Controversial letters, VAR, continuing to make an impact in the world of football. Clear and obvious, that's the phrase that the footballing bodies have put across regarding this new VAR thing. It just doesn't seem to be the case, does it? Clear and obvious. A clear and obvious decision should be overturned relatively quickly. We see it in other sports. Tennis, rugby, cricket. They all handle these new regulations, these new techniques very, very fast. And they've been a vital addition to these games. But within football, VAR continues to prove to be controversial. It continues to be an added weight of difficulty. I think there's going to be a lot of unhappy spectators, a lot of unhappy players, management and clubs going forward into next season. That I can be sure of. More controversy today. Michael Platini, the footballing legend, he's been arrested amid claims of corruption regarding the Qatar World Cup that's due to take place in 2022. More on that, I'm sure, as the news breaks throughout the day and the week. Not too many surprises regarding controversial corruption regarding that World Cup, though. I think we've all seen that coming. On to more positive news. England have qualified in the Women's World Cup for the second round, the round of 16. Of course, they beat Argentina the other day on Friday over the weekend. Lots of celebrations going on there in that camp. They're going to be playing against Japan in their final group game tomorrow evening from 8 o'clock. And also, the Under 21 Championships. That begins this week. That began yesterday. England play this evening at 8 o'clock against France. That's going to be a cracker of a game. Again, that's going to be taking place, kicking off from 8 o'clock. Coming up now, an interview that I had a few weeks back at St George's Park with Millie Bright.
Are you looking forward to this World Cup then?
Yeah, super excited. Can't wait to get out now.
Brilliant. What does your history involve when it comes to football? Because you've got a massive sporting background. Why did you go into football and choose that in the end?
Football's a career that you've got to go and do it now while you're young, I think. And for me, the horse is something I can go back to. So definitely took the plunge, moved to London, away from my family, to become professional playing for Chelsea. And I never regretted it, and I never will.
What was the difficulties with asthma like growing up? Because obviously that was something that impacted you greatly, and it's something that impacted a lot of sports people over the years. How did you move away from that?
It's tough, obviously it's still tough to this day now, but I think in my younger years that was the real tricky part. But I think for me, as I've said before, it comes down to educating yourself, and my mum did a great job of that and making me understand what it is, and you know, how I can recover from it, how I deal with it in certain situations, and how I can, you know, go without it affecting my football and, you know, my running or athletics or whatever it was when I was younger. I kind of just educated myself on that alongside my mum and knowing how to handle it.
Is it easier now than it was back when you were younger to kind of be almost honest about something like that? Because when you go back years gone by, it's very difficult for sports people to actually open up about something like asthma, because the fear of rejection, saying you've got something and this is going to impact on your ability to play. So, and a lot of players didn't want to come forward about that for fear that they would get rejected.
Yeah, definitely. I think obviously me, when I was younger, I didn't really see the need to say it because it didn't stop me.
Yeah.
And it wasn't really something that I felt I needed to speak about. So I kind of just kept it to myself, and like you said, it's a fear of rejection and she's going to struggle, she's not going to be able to do it kind of thing. But I've had moments where it's tried, people have tried to let it stop me, but I've like, no, I'm fine, like I can do it, put me through a fitness test and I'm fine.
And you proved it by playing for England.
Yeah, definitely, and I think it's, as long as you educate your kids on it and everyone knows how to handle it, it's fine.
Prediction please for this World Cup, what's going to happen? Are you going to bring home the gold?
That's the aim, and there's no reason why we can't go and do that, and the only people that will stop us getting there is ourselves. So I'm going to stay focused, stay hard working, we're going to win it.
Excellent. Thanks very much for
cheers, thank you.